My name is Ria Kaur Labana from BITS Goa, and we are working on IoT with Arduino and Raspberry Pi. We are a team of 6 people. So starting with what IoT actually stands for, IoT is actually Internet of Things. So what Internet of Things is, for those of you who do not know about it. So giving you the brief overview of the project. So we started with the sensor node. We have a sensor node. As you can see, the sensor node is actually collecting data from the sensors. Then we are sending this data to this data is being extracted by Arduino, which is a microcontroller. From there on, we will be sending this data to Raspberry Pi. We have a database on this Raspberry Pi. There it goes to dashboard. We are visualizing, actuating, and analyzing data on dashboard. So the main thing that comes is how do we send the data from Arduino to Raspberry Pi? So we have used 2 modules, ZigBee and ESP8266. So ZigBee is a wireless module that takes care of the wireless data transmission, and the other one is ESP8266, which is a Wi-Fi module. For ZigBee,
how much distance you are expecting between the Arduino and Raspberry Pi?
Raspberry Pi, it can be actually we have our setup here.
Because you are saying that either ZigBee or the Y2Me or whatever Bluetooth, it may be, I am expecting it.
Sir,
is a 10 to 15 feet.
XB has short distance.
100 meters maximum, right? So why do they disintegrate? They can be put together also.
ZigBee can work only for 15 to 20 meters.
That is what
so
I am saying. That what is the meaning in putting that at different location? Why didn't they are integrated together?
Sir, actually, suppose in industry there are so many, we have to calculate so many data from sensors. So what we are doing, we need at least 2 ZigBees to communicate. Suppose means we are making a sensor part, we are adding one ZigBees. They are configured as end or router, like end where the sensors are connected. And one ZigBee will be at the Raspberry Pi. It will be coordinated. That will be collecting data from all the ZigBees.
The correct answer is that there could be a single Raspberry Pi connected
and
to multiple
sensors. Yes.
But the basic technique these days is very popular is a Wi-Fi.
Yes, sir. That's why we switched
to Raspberry ESP. Comes with the Wi-Fi module built in, and then there are very 150 rupees Wi-Fi modules available for the sensors also.
But sir, Raspberry Pi is very costly, so.
Okay, carry on.
We started with ZigBee and then we moved on to ESP. ESP, as I already stated, is a Wi-Fi module. So, these are all the sensors that we have interfaced with Arduino, not going into the detail. This is the ZigBee I was talking about, the RX and the TX pin. As she already said, that there is one router and one coordinator. The communication takes place through the RX and the TX pin. Yeah, the configuration of ZigBee as end or router can be done using the XCTU software. A software comes, it can be done using Arduino Uno or directly through the USB port. This is the setup using ZigBee. This is the acting as the router side, and the coordinator one has other ZigBee attached to Raspberry Pi. This is the node 2. This means that both the ZigBees, both the routers, the previous one and this one, can communicate with the coordinator side with Raspberry Pi. This is the output that we obtained on ThingSpeak. ThingSpeak is actually an online dashboard that collects the real-time data and give you a plot of that. So there we have the temperature and all graphs. Now moving on to ESP. Why we switched on to ESP, I already gave the reason, because we have range limitation for ZigBee. But for ESP, we do not have any such thing. And ESP, we need Wi-Fi connectivity. So this is our ESP module. It can be programmed using Arduino IDE or the Lua firmware. This is the setup. We have just replaced ZigBee with ESP8266, and now on Raspberry Pi we don't need any other connection. So this is the output that we obtained on our dashboard. This was the one created by our people. So yeah, this is first we were using connecting ESP to and now we are using the node MCU1. So yeah, this is the actuation setup that we'll be demonstrating in few minutes. The actuation using a dashboard. This is the page for that. And now.
Hi, I am Abhishek Kumar. This is the flow of data from when the data is sent to the Raspberry Pi. Then the data flow from to the database. Then it goes to Node.js server. We fetch it through the Node.js server. And then it goes to dashboard. From that, we visualize the data and actuate the data. And then data analysis it came through Hadoop. Technologies we have used are MySQL for database, Node.js Express framework, and Socket.io. Chart libraries we have used are Eon charts for real-time charts and high charts for static charts. And now come to big data. as we have saving millions of data, means in one day there are like 1 lakh of data. So in a month we are around GBs of data, so we cannot process it in a relational database. So we are using Hadoop here, and then this is just the flow of Hadoop module. Conclusion, like we have transferred sensor data to dashboard using both Zigbee and ESP, and rendered real-time charts on the dashboard using different chart libraries and big data analysis using Hadoop, and actuated the devices using dashboard. This is our dashboard, we have created it. And just login page. This is our real-time dashboard. It is showing the real-time data. Our sensors are there. It is connected to the Zigbee. And our server is ESP, it's running ESP. And even the real-time charts are showing there. It variates and even shifts its y-axis according to the data changed. And this is the absolute value graph, means what's the exact data there. And you can see the different sensors like temperature, humidity, acceleration, intensity, anything. Let's move to someone else, acceleration. These are three axes, X, Y, and Z. We are showing it through a pie graph. And actually, it's not much moving, so it's like in a static data. And there are three options. We have visualizing, actuating, analysis. Let's go to actuation. These are our setup is there, and we can just control those all through our dashboard. We can switch on or switch off anything. Actuation. Yeah, okay, just switch on. Sir, it was working a few minutes ago. It was working few minutes ago, actually.
Our remote quizzes did not work properly.
You have to give a test.
Yeah.
Now, let me ask you another question. You have tested it in the normal environment where you have tried this out. So your Wi-Fi communication, etc. works properly.
Yeah.
There is one thing that you might want to write as an additional caution in a paragraph towards the end of your report, which you might even add. That while Wi-Fi is extensively being used by a whole lot of people, when you actually implement it in a industrial setup or a home setup or any other setup, this Wi-Fi connectivity has to be checked and cross-checked. And even small changes in the physical distribution of your sensors will have to result in one more checking. This will be your Achilles heel item. Everything else will work. This communication could create a problem.
Just go to analysis part. Actually, this is the previous day analysis. Actually, we don't have the for a month data and year data. We have options for that, like our sensors, previous day, current month, or current year. But as we have only previous day data, we are showing that only. Okay. So these are for all the sensors. Okay, this is for acceleration at x-axis.
Acceleration of what?
At x-axis, means the horizontal axis. Of a sensor. Of a sensor. Now go to actuation. Actually, our server is running in ASL lab. It's on Raspberry Pi, and we have
only one suggestion. You use the term actuation of data. You're not actually actuating data, you're actuating
device. Yeah, okay. Pardon me for that, actually actuating device.
Okay. Anything else?
So have you tried it with a real device, like a real fan or a real bulb?
Sir, there is a real bulb.
Yeah,
yes.
We have that.
There is a small difference between a bulb which is part of a lab gadget versus a bulb in a room.
Sir, actually no difference, because we are using SMPS power supply.
So there is a huge difference.
Sir, yes.
Because the existing bulb
that will
have
works.
Its own circuitry. And unless you rewire that circuitry, how will you be able to?
Sir, it needs AC supply, 230 volt. So that we are giving using SMPS, that power supply we have brought here. So that is.
So you are using the normal supply that is given to you.
Haan, sir, that is connected to the adapter, like.
Servo is working. The last one, servo is.
Servo, yeah.
And that's working. Kind of locking system, you can say.
Sir, like you can actuate it anywhere from in IIT, like in. If you open the dashboard in your cell phone, then also you can, if you press the button, like if the it is connected properly to the Wi-Fi, then it will work.
2.5 years ago, I had controlled a robot working in Rajesh Kosalkar's lab from
Delhi,
from Canada and US, using internet. But internally, it had exactly the same components. Your Arduino and Zigbee and other things on the robo itself. And he had actually put two different kind of cameras, one camera on the robo, so that when the robo moves, you can see what the robo is traversing. Another camera in the lab, so that you can see the robo itself when you are controlling. And both of these video streams were being put onto the internet through Wi-Fi. So Wi-Fi is an established mechanism, it works well. It's always these small things which create problems. But this is working.
Yeah. Okay.
So, okay. The different ESP modules are there, but the IP just got changed. One is working.
Okay, okay. Oh, IP got changed.
Yeah.
That's a standard.
Yeah. The timing just few minutes make it is working.
Good work.
Okay, okay. Can we go next?
Yeah.
Thank you, sir.